Hello, I'm Ryan Gerber, Hunter Product Specialist here at Hunter Engineering. Today we're going to cover some basic operational procedures with Hunter's new Ultimate ADAS. Hunter's Ultimate ADAS is based off of Hunter's WinAlign system. Many of you are going to be very familiar with the operation. We can still do wheel alignments, but now we've added the capability of adding ADAS target placement all around the vehicle. So let's start with how do we begin? So the first thing that we need to do is power on our sensors. What we'll do is we'll open the cabinet door on the sensor tower on this side. Simply press the button on the power supply for a moment. You'll see that it comes on and you can verify with the green light on the PC that it's on. In just a moment, the sensor tower will pair with the console and the display will come on. Once the sensor tower and console are powered up, the laser gimbals will go through a series of movements to initialize. Give it just a moment before continuing. At this point, you'll see some very familiar screens. Here we'll begin alignment just like we would with any of Hunter's WinAlign software. I'll begin the alignment, and if I were going to do just a standard wheel alignment with no ADAS procedures, I could continue by picking a vehicle. However, for today's procedure, we're going to do ADAS procedures. To initiate an ADAS procedure, we'll need a VIN. I'm going to use the barcode scanner to capture that VIN and move forward. Once the VIN is entered, you'll have a screen here to make sure that we want to do that ADAS procedure. So I will enable that ADAS procedure and I will continue without an alignment. We could continue with an alignment if that were part of our procedure. At this point, we need to mount our wheel targets. You will notice a new icon here on the bottom. Hunter's Ultimate ADAS program has opened. You will also see the WinAlign icon is present. Ultimate ADAS will automatically switch to the correct program for seamless operation. Should you need to manually toggle between the programs, it's as simple as clicking on the icon. To progress, we will need to add a qualifier here. We need to know if this is a four-wheel drive or a two-wheel drive. I'll choose the appropriate four-wheel drive model for this process. With this screen, we will choose what ADAS calibrations we need to do. We can either check those individually or drop down one row on the menu and select all. Returning to the top menu and confirming those calibrations. Now we're ready to compensate the vehicle. Once the vehicle is compensated, be sure to chalk the wheels so the vehicle doesn't move at any time during the procedures. Now that we've returned to the start calibration screen, let's talk about an important thing that we would want to do. Every morning, you will be prompted to do an ADAS gimbal calibration check. Let's go ahead and walk through that so you're familiar with it. Dropping down one row of keys, you'll see a calibration check. Simply click that. Our first step is determining home position. Take note of the camera beam and floor plane on-screen graphics. These will go through a progression from red to yellow to green as wheel targets are acquired and floor plane is calculated. You may see this progression at different times when moving the sensor tower or blocking camera sight. Should this happen, allow the system to reacquire target vision and recalculate the floor plane to green before continuing. Regarding home position, always follow the on-screen instructions and graphics to ensure that you're in the proper location. Ultimate ADAS will go to its calibration check height. It will instruct you to mount the targets that we've already mounted, and we will now do the calibration check. This is where the red lasers will come out and point at the front wheel targets on the top and the bottom and make a measurement. If the cameras and gimbals are in agreement, then you will get a pass on the screen and you can continue on. Let's talk about the accessories that will come with your Ultimate ADAS. Different manufacturers will require different accessories, but let's cover all of the bases. The first thing that everyone will have is this handheld remote. The handheld remote will control the console remotely so you don't have to walk up and engage with it. The next thing that all of you will have will be this barcode scanner. The barcode scanner will record different QR codes from some of these accessories for the printout and so that we know you use the correct target in the correct place. Everyone will also have a target rail and target carriages. On those carriages, we will have the target boards that mount to them. Then on the target boards, we will actually have those forward-facing camera targets or artwork. If you note, on the end of each one of these scrolls, you will see a number. That number will correspond to the on-screen graphics. Also, we have this flat plate radar, as well as surround view mats. Surround view mats may be rolled together because there may be more than one mat for a procedure. Again, you will see a number that will match an on-screen graphic, as well as QR codes that we will use for our barcode scanner for recording of the correct mat in the correct place. Last but not least, let's talk about the remote stand. The remote stand top will actually move so that you can aim that at the direction that the laser is pointing. The next thing you'll see here is the brake. So the brake will allow the remote stand to be placed level to the vehicle. Also, we need to adjust height. There's a trigger here. Pulling that trigger will allow for that height to be adjusted on the remote stand. You'll notice the remote stand has a receptacle on the front, and you may, depending on OE, have different accessories that will attach to this receptacle. Simply clip those in and continue on. Now let's look at the base of the remote stand. The first thing we want to point out is the bullseye. The bullseye is for the red dot laser. This allows for spot on placement. Next, we'll have a red line. The red line is to line up with the green line laser that will appear on the floor. Next, you will see these four pegs. You may have a procedure where the bottom of a target will need to be put between these pegs for stability. Now that we've covered the basic accessories, let's go ahead and move on to a procedure. For today's procedure, we're going to do a blind spot monitoring right front, otherwise known as pedestrian ADAS. Let's go ahead and get started. We'll go ahead and acquire those targets in home position. Ultimate ADAS will set its maximum height and display clear space at this point. This way, if you have any objects in the way of the calibration space, you can remove them. Next, I'm going to scan my target ID for documentation later. Now, Ultimate ADAS is using the red dot laser to display on the floor where I will be placing my remote stand. So I've got enough space there and I can see it. I will move to measuring the floor. Once I've measured the floor, I'll go ahead and place my target stand. Place the red dot into the crosshairs on my remote stand there on the base and align the green line with the line on the remote stand base as well. Next, I will center or square my remote stand here with the red dot laser on the crosshairs. That is a large adjustment. Now I will make a fine adjustment here again. Lock the remote stand down. Set my height for my radar reflector by putting the red laser in the collar. Double check that. I'll go ahead and move the aligner out of the way. Then I'll use my scan tool to actually finish the calibration. From that point, I'll be finished and I will submit all of these results to HunterNet for documentation later. Our next procedures with Ultimate ADAS are going to be the advanced surround view cameras. we're going to use what are called TV targets to complete these. TV targets are pretty neat. They fold up for easy storage, as well as have a magnetic front so that ultimate ADAS can grow with your business. So for our first procedure, we're going to do the front. Ultimate ADAS is already in home position. We've already set maximum height and always display clear space as per the manufacturer's specifications. Most importantly, with Ultimate ADAS, we always want that QR code so we know we put the right target in the right place. I'll go ahead and document the QR code and we'll see where we're going to place our first target over here with the red laser. We'll take a floor height measurement. Now we will display the green line and red dot so we can easily place the target per the on-screen instructions and orientation of the target. Using the red dot from Ultimate ADAS and the circle on the target, simply line the red dot up and bring the green line in, and you've placed your target. After placing the TV target, Ultimate ADAS will use the red laser to go ahead and confirm placement. We'll go ahead and document again the target ID for future documentation, and we'll repeat the same process for the remaining two targets. We've now finished placing the targets for the front advanced surround view camera. You complete this same process following on-screen guidance for orientation and placement when setting the targets for the left and right camera procedures as well. However, for the rear camera procedure, it will be slightly different. We'll be placing a mat, number 340. Just roll out the mat. Place the target on the mat and scan the QR code. Then finish setting the last two targets following the on-screen instructions. For all procedures, go ahead and use the infotainment center to finish the calibration. And then make sure that you send all of the documentation to HunterNet. Thank you for watching.